Bonjour.
Hello, my name is Mathieu Bonnier. I am responsible for the development and the concept of the light boat. Hello, my name is Olivier Cataline. I'm a rowing instructor. Today we're going to show you how to use the boat, in particular the techniques and movements to use when rowing, so that it's easy and accessible to everybody.
En ce qui concerne la tenue des avirons, ça se tient bien au bout de l'aviron.
In order to hold your oars correctly, you must ensure that the hand is at the end of the oar. In order to achieve this, you should put your thumb over the end of the oar. It also allows you to keep a small lateral pressure onto the oar to avoid it being pulled out of the rowlock, as demonstrated.
Donc en gardant une petite pression avec le pouce, ma rame va suivre le.
By keeping a little bit of lateral pressure with my thumb, the oar will follow the correct path as I row. My fingers are lightly wrapped around the end of the grip. There is no need to grip too tightly onto the oar, just to pull with the fingers.
Pas besoin de serrer trop fort les poignets. Il suffit juste de tirer dessus, et le mouvement se fait tout seul. Une fois qu'on est arrivé sur l'avant,
once we come back to the beginning of the stroke, we still have our thumbs over the end of the oar, which gives me the lateral pressure necessary to keep the oar in the rowlock here. A nice light grip on the oar. Don't hold on too tight.
Et ensuite, on va venir pousser sur les jambes toujours avec le dos droit. On est donc sur une face.
As we start to come back through the power stroke, we keep the back straight, and as we cross the hands, the right hand passes under the left and sits under the wrist right up until the end of the stroke, when they will be slightly parted. When we finish the stroke, the legs are extended and the arms are flexed. All that is left to do is push down with the hands to bring the oars out of the water. So we bring down the forearms to bring the oar out of the water.
Donc on abaisse les avant-bras pour sortir l'appel de l'eau. On revient retendre les bras, rebasculer un tout petit peu le corps vers l'avant.
We extend the arms once more, gently bringing the shoulders forward, and then bend the knees. Once again, the arms are crossed with the right hand under the left. The arms extend beyond being crossed. We let the oars fall into the water and start to push once more with the legs. Again, we are back into the pulling part of the stroke. The arms cross once more. No need to pull too much with the back, and at the end of the stroke, the arms are once more parted. We can push down and bring the oars out of the water to complete the stroke and start again.